So, how is it going, everyone? Welcome to some Champ King. A pretty, well, interesting game to say the least. And a game that even lets you know what OBS settings to use. Now, that's something that I haven't seen any other game do. Though it's pretty clear that this game is more oriented towards streaming and everything, right? As you can see by, well, how painful it is. And we all know how everyone likes to see other people, you know, playing with a lot of pain in their playthroughs. And this game will definitely have tons of it. Now, apparently, the developers classify this as a tactical leaping adventure. I don't know what that means, but I do know what the game is about, and that's why I say how painful it is. I've seen it myself. Sadly, this is not a blind run. I already seen this game before, but I still didn't see most of the game. I mostly seen the DLCs, and I'm obviously not gonna start with the DLCs yet. I'm gonna go with the main game and then gonna, you know. Yeah, I know, right, Yami? Thanks! Thanks for reading it. How is it going, Yami and Mage? How are you both doing? Anyways, the good thing is that this is also another game that allowed me to use my sits, my numpad sits button as a jump button. So that's also pretty cool. I don't know if the camera is right where I put it. I hope it is. It might block some specific platforms, maybe. I hope not. I don't know. Super addicted to Monster Hunter. Yeah, I know a friend that is incredibly addicted to Monster Hunter as well. So that game definitely is doing something right. Anyway, speaking of addiction, let's see where this is gonna take me. Also, other than tactical leaping adventure, this game also says there is a smoking hot babe at the top. So, you know, sadly, I already know which one of them is, one of the DLCs. So sadly, I can't make any joke about that, because I know that that's quite literal. But yeah, there is something waiting for us at the top. But the real question is, can we get to the top? Probably not, but I will try my best. Hey Kyle, how is it going? Came right in time. Legend has it there is a smoking hot bay at the top. Okay, that's what I was talking about. Alright. Well, you have heard the legend too. You're gonna get that babe right? Damn, making me sound like a degenerate. I mean, more than usual. Alright. Thanks, old man. Alright. Oh, what's this? Is this a secret? Alright, probably not. So the controls in this game are pretty simple, as well as the objective. Basically, you have left, right, and jump. Those are the controls, literally, nothing else. So basically, yes, as the name suggests, you are supposed to jump a lot. And that sounds easy, right? Well, the thing here is that there is no checkpoints in this game. So, as easily as you can jump up, you can just fall down. Just as easily. Hey, Yannick, how is it going? Also, let me see. Okay, it seems like my camera doesn't really block much of the game, but let me know if it's blocking something, right? Like, right there, I know that it's blocking a little bit, but hopefully it doesn't really block that much. Because, I mean, if I make it smaller, it's gonna be incredibly small. So, hopefully it doesn't really block anything relevant. Anyways, without any further ado and any further bullshit, let's just get into this. So, for those who don't know, also, the jumps vary in strength, right? So you have a short hop, like a really, really short hop. Kind of high jump, right? And the highest jump. So obviously you are supposed to decide which one you should use. Sadly, a lot of these times, like a lot of these jumps are gonna be just trial and error. That means that we're probably gonna have to jump through the same shit over and over again. If you wanna hurt yourself, there are other ways. I know, but you know, I feel like this one is the one that a lot of people can enjoy, not just me. Red Crown Roots. Alright. Nice. That's a pretty nice start. Yeah, basically, a lot of the NPCs here, or I should say every single one of the NPCs here, kind of mocks you about how you fucking suck. But, yeah. Also, something really important that let me show you right now is that you can bounce off of platforms like this. Well, not like that. Like this. And this is a lot of times incredibly necessary to progress. Some jumps are exclusive to doing that. So you gotta take that into account. Hey Nitori, how is it going? Oh shit. Also, if I want to investigate what's in the next screen, I shouldn't do any horizontal jump or anything stupid like that. I should do a vertical jump. Nice, I fell through the same hole twice. You caught a fairy? Well, hopefully it's no fairy from Gensokyo. Too bad. Man. This old man is a fucking stoner. Even more than any of you in chat. That's already saying a lot. Fuck. Need to sleep? Hey, that's fine, don't worry. I mean, I'm used to that. To the fact that you need to sleep. So don't worry about it. What counts is just saying hi. Saying hi, it's enough. Okay, that was a really short hop. Short enough to not even let me jump to the platform. So I do a vertical one here to see what's coming. So basically, I'm assuming that this is a full jump from here, right? Yep. This is gonna hit my head. Is this also a full jump or is this a short hop? I'm gonna try a full jump. Okay, no. If you jump and you hit your head, you cut the trajectory so you don't have to hit your head, or you have to hit your head at late. The fuck is this old man talking about? She called Luna child. Luna child. For some reason, according to the Toho poll, Luna child is my favorite fairy of the tree. Which is complete bullshit, as I already say that Star Sapphire is my favorite one. But you know, I mean, it's not like I really care about them that much, so... is that crow gonna be a problem, or is that just... Wait, what's up here? Okay, I need to go here. No, he just fucked off, nice. So I'm assuming full jump from here. This might be a full jump too. Yep. Okay, this might be a tricky one. It is a tricky one, okay. Can I jump from here? Probably no, I don't think I can jump from there. Well, it's gonna be pretty weird if I could jump from there. According to that poll, Star Sapphire is your third favorite character? Damn. You really... Okay, I mean, it makes sense considering it comes from Kyle. I'm not surprised. Damn. You gotta watch it. One of these days, those guys in suits are gonna come to your house. They're gonna pay you a visit. And it's not gonna be a fun time. So Star Sapphire is your third favorite character. I think that might be the first time that I hear someone say that Star Sapphire is in their top 3. I mean, other than Teen Titans fans, but you know, that's another Star Sapphire. That's pretty funny, because if you search Star Sapphire on Google, you know. Some results are gonna link to Toho and some others are not. Which makes sense, but still funny. And not again, right? Okay, how the fuck do I do this jump? So it has to be low enough that I don't hit my head. But I don't think... I think it has to be from here. So I get down... Like, I get down in time to not hit the trunk. But I also don't have to jump high. Because if I jump high, I'm obviously gonna hit the trunk. So something like that? Almost. It's something along those lines. Maybe I need to be... Oh, fuck. I need to be a little bit more to the left. So, around here? That was really close. It didn't work either. Maybe from here? Maybe I need to be to the... like, the left corner. Like, right here. Maybe? Let's see. Alright, that works. So I'm assuming that I need to go there. Do I go left or do I go right? Let's see. No, I need to go... Because I don't think... If I do a full jump to the right... Oh, it works. Never mind. Okay. So from here... Gotcha. Oh, and this is one of the things that I was mentioning earlier. This section right here, you're supposed to bounce off the wall. Not like that, by the way. Well, we're back home. I see. Well, this is basically a little glimpse of the pain that we are about to experience throughout the whole game. So I hope you like seeing pain. Maybe this will be better than I thought. Of course it's better than I thought for a fucking sadistic fuck like you, of course. But you know, I wouldn't like you any other way. If you weren't the sadistic fuck you are, you wouldn't be yummy. So yeah, that makes you unique here. Really, really like how sadistic you are. It begins, I know, right? Yeah, but the good thing about this is that most of the hard stuff is not really about execution. It's about knowing what to do and obviously remembering, right? Because, you know... doing these jumps, like, you obviously need a specific strength for the jumps. So, if you know the strength of the jumps, executing them is not that hard. Not yet, at least. There are gonna be some parts that it is gonna be indeed hard to execute them at the same time. But, we still haven't reached those parts. So, I should bounce. Fuck. Well, at least I fall there. I think I'm supposed to do a full jump from like the very edge to the left, obviously. And see what that's gonna give me. So, let's see. Like from here, I do a full jump to the left? No. Fuck. Nice. Hey, old man, is it going? You know, I've been jumping around a little bit. And it turns out... You know... I will probably have a better motivation for this if what was waiting for me on top was a Toho character. Sadly, it's not a Toho character. But, yeah. Go for the fairy? I know, right? What's the difference, right? You know, I say that, but the fucked up thing is that every fairy in Toho is a fucking child. So I should probably watch my mouth. I know that for a lot of you are gonna say that, well, fairies are childs most of the time. No, that's not true. Fairies are just little things that have wings. Like, for example, I mean, the most known example is, you know, Tinkerbell, right? Tinkerbell is not a child. She's just tiny. But in Toho, however, not only they are tiny, but they are also childs, children, I mean. Yeah, that's one of the weird words that have a shitty plural form that you have to remember. Yeah, fuck English, by the way. Okay. That sucks. Wait, you can get there from... Why would I want to get there, by the way? I don't think that has any advantage. No, you probably don't even want to get to the right side on that screen. You probably just want to... Like... That's probably gonna stop your fall if you fall from up there. Or something like that. Damn it. Fucking trunk. Anyways, how have your day been? My day was pretty interesting because this is the first time that I, you know, I streamed this early, right? Well, not the first time, but like the first time where it's gonna be like something not out of the ordinary, right? Because as you know, I changed my work schedule, so now I basically will do everything 1 hour earlier. So I gotta say that I am kinda enjoying the change of schedule. I mean, I obviously prefer the previous one, but it's not like I really have a choice, so yeah. Mod the game, change the bay to Star Sapphire, and the protagonist to the Sin Heads of Shikieki. Wait, why Shikieki? What does she have to do with anything? Did I miss something about Shikieki? Do you know something about Shikieki I don't know? Huh? Oh, the Sin Heads! You mean... Oh, I know who you mean. Wow, what a fucking... Of course that comment is gonna come from fucking Kyle. Of course. I didn't expect anything less. Yeah, I know who you mean. Fucking... You know, one of these days, they are gonna come on your door. They are gonna come on your door, and you are gonna have to open the door. And when you open the door, you're gonna get your ass busted. Both figuratively and literally, right? And when that happens... The Sin Heads always appear in the Shiki videos. Well, yeah, it makes sense, because, I mean, Shiki is supposed to be a shad, so if they are sinners, it makes sense that she shushes them, right? But yeah, what a fucking pervert. I wonder how many products on DLSI you bought that has the Sin Heads. I really wonder. Oh, have a good night, Nitori. Thanks. Thanks for hanging out. Don't open the door. Well, if he doesn't open the door, trust me, they will make sure the door opens. One way or another. Also, I'm pretty sure now, upon, you know, closer inspection, that I might not need to do this jump. In fact, I don't think I can do this jump. I'm pretty sure I can't. I think I have to jump to the right. Well, not that much to the right. Does this game have three buttons? Yes. It's left, right, and jump. Those are the three buttons that this game has. So basically, you can play it with one hand, while with the other hand, you write a story. What? What do you think? I was gonna say right there. Come on, Kyle. I know what you were thinking. Huh, that's not a full jump. Fuck. So yeah. Damn it. I'm doing shorter jumps than I should for that. But yeah. Honestly, I've been thinking, as I said yesterday, about which other game I would play other than this. And, you know, I've been thinking that a good idea, maybe not, maybe yes. Because, you know, I hope that I'm not gonna shins this, but my ISP, ever since that guy came here and did some magical shit, my internet is being like pretty stable, right? So maybe we could finally get into playing. Yeah, Yami already knows what I'm gonna say. Maybe we can finally get into playing Rabby Ribby. We can finally get into play that game. Your hand is for wiping your tears. Yeah, that one is more accurate, alright? That one is definitely more accurate. Okay, I think this is the jump that I'm supposed to do. But what about this jump? Oh, never mind. Oh, fuck. Well, at least I didn't fall too farther away. So it could have been worse. It still can be worse. Okay. So what's the jump here? A really short jump, right? I say short jump. If they ain't have a button for each type of jump, it will be better. It wouldn't be as painful, though, so it will miss the purpose of the game. Yeah, Rabby Ribby. Prepare your ace. Your ace. Your ass. And be Raiden. Oh, hope you like Metroidvanias with lots of secrets. No, I actually don't. But I don't remember who told me that secrets are not that important in that game. So I can just go, you know, basically oonga boonga, defeat everyone and not give a shit about secrets, and I will still do fine for the most part. Okay, this is a full jump. It seems it is. Yep. Colossal Drain. Okay. Is this gonna be a... yeah. Okay, that works. So we got into a drain. I don't know why the drain will be up there, but I mean, sure, why not? Your ace, I know, right? The secrets sure help. Yeah, but you know, searching for secrets to me fucking sucks. So, yeah, I probably won't try to get them unless they are blatantly obvious. So, yeah. How do I do this? Is this a full jump from here? Yep. No, this is a wall jump. Or, well, a wall bounce, is that how you call it? Okay. I don't think this is a wall jump. Nope. Do I wanna do that? Do I really? Okay, that works. Should I jump where this asshole is? Maybe. Alright. Okay, so at least we got here. I'm pretty sure this is a full jump to the right. It is. Oh, we got a pretty cozy house up there. I play on hard the first time and got stuck in some bosses. I mean, that's fine. I mean, I literally got stuck for like 3 streams in a single boss in Wings of B, though that's probably a bad example, because I actually quit that game, but you know. So we got into a house. Is that legal? Is there someone here? Looks nice. Okay, that's a pretty big house. What you cooking? Who the fuck do I... Maybe... Oh, maybe I have to get here and then here. That works. False King's Keep. Damn it. Hard is fine, good difficulty, you can trust my judgment. Yeah, I can sure trust Yami's judgment. I didn't use items until very later. Well, I'm not sure. I mean, honestly, you already know this, but I'm gonna repeat it just in case. I don't like Metroidvanias, right? So, you know, I'm not sure if I'm gonna fully play it, but I'm gonna make an attempt. I mean, I did an attempt with La Mulana. Even though I quit, I definitely tried. You know, it didn't... It ended up not working out. Yes, that's true, but you know... What can you do? You got the game and DLCs? Yes, the DLCs on this game are completely free, by the way. As far as I know, I think they are free, right? I mean, I don't remember paying for any DLCs. Although, at the same time, I also don't know if I unlocked them, so... Yeah. I think they are free, though. But, you know, I obviously want to beat the main course before going into a DLC. Wait, you mean Rabi Ribi, not this game. Oh, sorry. About Rabi Ribi, I don't even remember what the DLCs were in that game. Yeah, I don't even know... that the game had DLCs. I don't remember if I bought them or not. I mean, it's been a while since I bought Rabi Ribi, so I honestly have no idea if it has, if I have the DLCs or not. It's not as hard as people make it out to be. I mean, I could say the same about Touhou, and that will probably... I will feel like I'm saying bullshit if I say something like that. Because, you know, it's pretty easy to forget how hard a game is once you're used to it. But I don't know if, you know, if it's really fair to call it easy. Oh, you could just jump there. So I don't know if you're supposed to. You're not supposed to bounce that many times. Fuck. Well, at least here, no matter how many times we fail on this house, we cannot really fall that far yet. Special emphasis on yet. Standard mode or alternative? The difficulty is very customizable. How many difficulties are there in that game, by the way? Fuck. It's like he's purposely trying to avoid that fucking platform. Maybe I should do this. No, not that, god damn it. That's fine. Huh, I didn't mean to do that, but sure. So there we go. Oh, I can probably do a full shunt there. And I fucked up again. Nobody's normal hard, very hard, bunny extinction and DLC impossible. Wow. Those are quite some difficulties, alright? You'll be very hard hell, not very hard. Damn, so are you telling me that I should play on hard? I usually don't play games other than Danmaku games when they are not on the hardest difficulty, but maybe I should do it for this game. Maybe I should listen to your advices and actually, you know, not play the hardest difficulty is probably the best idea. Oh, that didn't work. Ah, too short. Casual for the scrubs. Hard is a good starting point. I did hard no healing item run. Damn. If you don't like it, there is an NPC that can change it to normal if you want. Danmaku skill transfer easy. I see. Interesting. Yeah, I'm kinda excited to play that game, but I don't know. The game being Metroidvania, it's a little bit of a turnoff for me, but I mean, I already have it, so it's not like I have much choice. Okay, so you can get in here. Okay, that's not a full jump. Good to know. That's actually not a full jump. Also, there's a note in there. Should I read it? I mean, it's probably not gonna be anything important, but it's probably gonna be something like an achievement or I don't know. Something like that. Now, the problem is that if I want to read that note, I have to do a little bit of pretty weird jumps to get in there, probably. I went orc. Nice. So, apparently you're telling me that hard is actually hard. Because, you know, a lot of games have the hard difficulty not really being hard, but you're telling me that that game does have a pretty hard, well, hard difficulty, right? That's the case, then it's gonna be interesting. What happens if I choose walk off? Oh, you bounce. Even when you walk off, you bounce off the walls. That's interesting to know. Ah, too short. But how will I even read that note? No, I will have to risk a lot if I want to read that note. I don't know if I want to risk it, so I guess that note can wait. Damn, if you do it a little bit higher than what you're supposed to do, you're fucked. That seems to be a pretty precise jump. The items can make almost any battle winnable. Do you really have to use items in that game? Like, are items really necessary? Or, like, the game is so hard that you will need to use items? Demaku patterns aren't that hard, it's just more damage and a bit more speed. I see. Well, we will see. I'm a little bit worried about the bit rate, though. I don't know if the bit rate is gonna be... like... you know... it's gonna be a problem or not. Even though I usually try to stream with 5,000 or 6,000 bit rate. I don't even know if that's gonna be enough. Consumables, no items either, but for that you need to know the game like the palm of your hand. Damn. So I guess I do need to use items. Well, that's fine. I mean, I don't mind using items. Oh, I forgot. That's not how you do it. Damn it. Using items and not consumables. Alright. So, wait, what's the difference between items and consumables? I mean... when you say items, you mean like attack items, right? Items are like buffs for your chump, wall chump. Oh, consumables are heals. Okay. So, basically buffs versus heals. Yeah. I guess I can do that. Why not? I still don't know how to do this fucking shunt though. So basically this is the full shunt. You can do a slightly shorter shunt like that. But, oh, well I got here. I could get to the note if I do Shumper's poem. Huh. That, is this written by a stoner? Probably. What happens if I... okay, that works. Oh, I got to this platform. But I don't think this platform... well, it's the same shit. Items are passives too. The game was designed in a way you can complete it without even getting your basic weapon. Damn. Has a metric fuck ton of achievements. Yeah, usually... I don't really... care that much about achievements. Oh, damn, I got here. Full jump to the right? Can I even do a full jump to the right here? Yep, I can. Oh, fuck. Because if I do this, yeah, that's not gonna work. So are you telling me this is gonna suck. This is gonna be potentially one of the first really, really bad jumps that is gonna cost a lot of time to recover from. So I hope you look forward for that. Because this jump is impossible to do from here as far as I know. So you need to risk it and go there. Damn. Well, I have to measure that jump correctly. Like that. Well, I didn't measure that correctly, but that's fine. So, how do I do that? Yeah, not like that. Seems like it's an almost full jump without being a full jump. Not that one though. Well, even that progress loss is not that bad. I feel like the real bad progress loss is gonna be if I fall from here. Oh. That was alive? Damn. So everyone here is at the Shenerate, huh? I mean, it makes sense. I mean, everyone is torturing themselves to reach a hypothetical girl. So, yeah, I'm assuming that they are all fucking degenerates, alright? Damn it. Well, that's definitely unfortunate. Alright. Now, the problem with this game, other than the fact that you lose a lot of progress from some of the chumps, is that when you try to recover, you kinda... Well, you obviously forget most of the times about how to make the chumps to get back up. So you start falling even further, right? That obviously makes beating the game a pretty hard task. At least, you know, it's kind of all about memorization. There's no RNG, right? The game... Oh, I already read that. No checkpoints or saves. That's a luxury to have. Of course there are no checkpoints or saves. This is Shump King, dude. The only checkpoint you're gonna get is the starting screen. Well, I mean, technically the game tells you that it automatically saves, but that obviously means that it automatically saves, you know, your current position, right? So if you fall, it obviously is gonna save that too. Think about it like Dark Souls, right? Dark Souls saves absolutely everything. So if you try to rage quit in Dark Souls, and trust me, I already tried it, it doesn't work. Like, you're gonna spawn getting killed. So yeah, that's pretty much what this game is also. So it's getting saved constantly. But you know, that's fine to me. I mean, that's kind of like the purpose of the game. It wouldn't be frustrating otherwise. Like, why do you think so many people rage like crazy to this game? Oh, well, this is a bad one. It's a bad situation. Oh, fuck. Well, seems like we keep going lower and lower. But yeah. Oh, why did I do a high jump? I know that that's not a high jump. You know, I mean, I'm a Touhou player, so I'm kinda used to suffering like this. That's a full jump to the right. Well, at least we're back here. There we go. Another game that I also been looking at, that I also have, I bought it on the winter sale. It's Azure Reflections, right? You know, that Touhou fan game that is in 3D. That game looks pretty interesting. But hopefully it doesn't melt my PC. Because apparently it's pretty poorly optimized, according to the system requirements. So we never know if it's gonna be enough or not. Hopefully it is. Nice. Damn it. Down the Drain. Played back when it was called My Hannah. Yeah, I probably can try that. Yeah, I know. It ran fine, but probably the remaster of that game. I mean, you know how bad Dark Souls 1 remaster runs in a lot of PCs. Although maybe they fixed it. Or at least hopefully they fixed it, because I want to play that one too. But you know, you never know. A lot of times remasters are like excessively tuning graphics and shit to the point where running them on a non-high-end PC, it's close to impossible. Which obviously sucks, but yeah. It's like you can't do much about, right? Can't do much about it. But you know, kinda wanna play it. The good thing about that game, and what I really like, is that apparently you can customize your characters. That's one of the first Danmaku games that actually allows you to do that. Like, I don't recall many other Danmaku games that just allows you to visually customize your character. I mean, you have something like Lenin 4 that allows you to customize it gameplay-wise, but it doesn't allow you to customize it visually, right? But Azure Reflections apparently lets you do it. And by playing the game, apparently you can unlock customizables too. So, that's pretty good in my book. That's definitely pretty good in my book. Also, I really wish this game had a little bit more music. Though, I know that the game has music, but it doesn't have music in the first screens. It's a little bit whack. If you're not in like the close to the final screens, you get no music. You only get ambient sounds. I know that it is to add to the atmosphere, right? Like, I understand that, but come on, dude. Azure Reflections, you have a camera mode. And that's the Kyle comment of the hour. Yeah, but I think it is... then my answer is gonna be even worse, but... that is something that they show in the trailer, and I'm pretty sure it's censored. Like, if you try to look up like that, I'm pretty sure you can. You get like a sticker that says, "Don't look, fucking pervert." But I don't know if that was only for the trailer or if it's actually in the game. You get an achievement when trying to look up Sakuya's skirt. Damn, so the fucking developers knew their audience a little bit too well. God damn it. Aw, come on. Seems like, for some reason, this section, the one in, like, the initial section of the sewer, was not that hard the first time, but now it's costing me a shit ton to be able to do it. I don't know exactly why. Maybe it was always hard and I just got kinda lucky or something like that. Maybe. Who knows? Fuck. Even this section right here, I don't remember it being that hard. Nice, and we keep falling further and further. Because why not? Oh, well, that's a pretty direct jump right there. Also, I know that this is needless to say, because you already probably figured it out on your own, but I'm just gonna say it just in case, right? It's more than likely that I'm not gonna complete this game. I just want you to know that. Like, that's the most likely scenario, by the way. So, you know, just so you don't get disappointed afterwards, because I know that you might or might not, I don't know, look forward to me beating this game. It's probably not gonna happen. But at least I can say I didn't try, right? So there is that. Nice. Been a while since I've been here. We can get we can keep getting lower if we want to. No, that's not a full jump. That's a short hop. Oh, hey, old man, how is it going? Instead of falling down, have you thought about jumping up? I kinda thought about it. But, you know, sometimes falling down is just a little bit better. Game gonna get the La Mulana treatment? Probably. That's the most likely scenario. Because the thing about this game is that it's mostly, I don't really think, I mean, it is a good stream experience, but at some point, well, especially at the starting point, it's like so dull, right, to watch. And to play as well, right? I mean, if it had at least a little bit of music, you can kind of leave this as a background or some shit, right? Like, you don't even need to watch it. But it doesn't have any. Yet. It does have afterwards. But until we actually get to the section with music, it's probably gonna, you know, a lot of time is gonna happen. It's gonna, whatever, I can't talk. I can't talk and jump at the same time. It's a little bit hard. No, I'm just kidding. It's just that my English sucks. It's just that I try to mask it to not look like an idiot. Whew, well, that was really close. Also, I like how the water suddenly stops there. Like, there is some magical force that makes the water just, you know, stop flowing after that. How did I do that jump, by the way? I feel like I did that jump on my first try, and now I can't do it. I completely forgot how I did it. Nice. Latino American English. I know. You know, I will put some music here, but Twitch wouldn't be happy about it. Because, you know, lately I've been listening to a lot of rap, right? I mean, in fact, I link on my Discord a Snoop Dogg song. It's pretty cool. But the problem is that if I do that, not only Twitch is not gonna like it, but if I try to sing along, Twitch is gonna like it even less. Need to get at Asia Reflections. Wow. I see we have another fellow degenerate right here. Really appreciate it now. Like, really appreciate being able to share my degeneracy with all of you. Because, you know, there are some people in this chat that, yes, they are here and they deny being complete degenerates, even though they clearly are. Yes, I'm looking at you, Yami. But, you know, I like the ones that are actually, you know, they are honest about that. I don't think this core is gonna get my ass banned. Do you think I'm a Dishon? I will say you're a moderate Dishon. So basically, someone that is a degenerate, but not that much of a degenerate, and at the same time, you don't really hide it. Like, you don't deny it, I mean. So, you know, it's a moderate degenerate. Obviously not on the level of Kael, that's for sure. Kael is the master degenerate in this chat. It's the top tier. Knee deep. Yeah, Kael. Don't deny it, but I don't go showing around my shit to everyone. Yeah, I know, I know. But you know, I like when people share their degeneracy. Not on Twitch, obviously, because that's against the rules. But you know, sharing it in Discord and stuff, it's pretty nice. Because you know, those kind of things, you wouldn't be able to share them anywhere else. And a lot of people, even if you could share it, they wouldn't feel comfortable with it. But, honestly, it's great that people like Kael don't have any problem with it. Because I also don't have any problem with it. Again, as long as you don't do it on Twitch, and as long as you don't explicitly do it. You gotta be smart about it. You gotta cast the magic numbers. It has to be that way. You can't just link it directly. So if you do that, I'm gonna link you directly to the to the ban zone. Don't bore people with it that are not interested. Yeah, I know. I know, that's the reason why I always, you know, I always say how much I'm glad that Kael is such a big degenerate. Because I don't mind sharing things with him, and he also doesn't mind sharing things with me. So that's great. And obviously, we don't, as I say, we don't do it explicitly. We just do it in our own language. So, you know, it's fine. Just come down to common sense. Yeah, I mean, obviously I'm not gonna link an actual image of, you know, some big ass that has nothing to cover it. Right? I mean, yes, I won't do that. But, you know, yeah, sharing those numbers is fine to me. And that's such a good thing. Because who the fuck is gonna tell you something about writing numbers, right? I mean, it's no, you don't even know what that is. You don't even know which work that's referencing to. And, I mean, if you actually search for it, you find it, and you don't like it, all I can say is that you took the trouble to find it, so it means that you were interested in it in the first place. So at that point, I will say that it's kinda your fault. It's always the same numbers. I honestly don't know what those numbers are. Like, I don't know which work it is. I wanna search for it, but not now. Remind me on Discord, by the way. From Kael. You say that he always posts those numbers? I honestly, as I say, don't know what those numbers reference. Oh, of course it references that. Damn. Yeah, I have to read that one. I mean, everyone is out there choking about that work. And I just don't get, well, I mean, I get it because it's not hard to understand, but I never read it, so I'm kind of like out of the loop with that one. So I gotta read it. I gotta read it and you know. You know, just read it, obviously. I wouldn't do anything else with it. I'm just reading it out of curiosity. Obviously nothing else. I like how I left for half an hour and you're back at the bottom again. What you mean back at the bottom? This is not the bottom. This is almost the bottom, which is not the same thing. The real problem is that last jump at the end. And well, this first jump is also a little bit annoying. Because it's pretty easy to hit what's up there. Okay, doing a full jump kinda works there. You don't have to do a short one, that's for sure. How did you even get back here? Well, you're starting to understand how this game works. Well, I could explain that to you, but let me just show it instead, because that's gonna be easier than explaining it. So, you know, you do all of this that you're seeing right here, right? And then that happens. So, by seeing that, you can pretty much understand how you can get quickly back to the bottom, right? No need to show me. Well, don't worry about it. I can show you even if I don't want to, because the game is gonna make sure I will show it. So yeah. And you know, obviously, I think this is also needless to say, but this game has a pretty high tilting effect, right? So when you're tilted, you obviously make a lot more mistakes, right, than if you weren't tilted. Now, the problem with that is that you usually get tilted after you fall, right? And if you get tilted after you fall, the most likely outcome is that you're gonna fall even more because you're gonna make mistakes because you're tilted. So, yeah. It's, you know how they like to call it, a quicksand effect. You know, when you're in quicksand, the more you try to get out of it, the more you're gonna sink into it, right? That's why it's called the quicksand effect. So yeah, this is pretty much a game that has a lot of that. There is also another game that has a lot of that. I wonder if you can guess which one it is. Let me give you a hint. It starts with T and it ends with OHO 12. No, that game is pretty big when it comes to quicksand effect. Now, the problem is that the quicksand effect in that game is not because of tilting. It's because of the shitty mechanics that the game has. Yeah, the power... exactly, the one power game. That's exactly why... oh, I forgot about that. That's exactly why Toho 12... like, the more you die, the more likely you are to die again. That fucking sucks. It's like, it really feels like Sun didn't even test that game. Like, Toho 12, I can't say it enough times how much I hate that game. Or maybe not say hate, but like, heavily dislike it. Gradius 12. More like a sinkhole. Yeah, more like, you know, a black hole. Yeah, that's Toho 12. Once you enter the event horizon, there's no going back. You're sucked in. You're sucked in. Good luck trying to get out of it, but spoiler alert, you won't. So instead you have to retry all that shit again from scratch. Yep, that's Toho 12 for you. Really, really amazing and balanced game. Fair, especially fair and balanced game. But yeah, what can you do? The game has awesome music and also awesome characters, but the game itself fucking sucks, dude. Okay, so you're supposed to do this, and then not that. Okay, so it's not the shortest jump you can do, it's a little bit higher than the shorter jump, than the shortest jump, to be able to get into those cages. Also has no bugs. Yeah, well, I mean, for a scrub like me, getting a score overflow is pretty hard, you know, because... You know, survival guy right here. I don't play for score. And honestly, before playing Toho 12 with score, like before scoring Toho 12, I'd rather beat this game. That's already saying a lot, by the way. Doesn't have to be that short, but not that long either. Yeah, that's fine. Okay. So those jumps are fine. Now, this jump is more problematic than you think. Because after this jump, you have an interesting section where you don't need to worry about falling. But this jump is pretty hard by itself. As you can see, it has to be pretty precise. Like, pretty, pretty precise. Obviously, not as precise as most of the other jumps in the game. But, precise enough. Let's just say that. It has to be on a pretty sweet spot that is hard to achieve. Damn, someone is smelling my feet. Damn. Good shit. Well, if anyone is a degenerate in this chat, you can feel good that you're probably not gonna be as much as a degenerate as that guy. Well, except for Kyle, but that's fine. We all like Kyle in here. Kyle is our national treasure. I thought I could play UFO, but I got destroyed. Yeah. The best way to play UFO is to not play it. That's definitely the best way to play that game. It's sad, yes. But what can you do? Well, it's pretty sad if you're a fan of Byakuren. Thankfully, I'm not that big of a fan, as you can see by the sorter that I did the other day of most of the Toho 12 characters, except for Nue. But yeah, I got to stage 5 first try, looks more beatable than Subterranean Animism. Yeah, but Subterranean Animism is hard because of patterns. It's not hard because of bullshit mechanics. So at least with Subterranean Animism, what you can do is, you know that you have to work hard, but, you know, the deaths are something that you really can't blame on the mechanics. You are just... You know, you just need a little bit more practice. With Toho 12, however, even though there are obviously some things that might also just need more practice, there are a lot of other deaths in that game that are about how bullshit every mechanic in that game is. Cancer shots. Wait, what do you mean? No. Okay. You're saying that Morrison Alice is a cancer shot. You didn't should say that. You didn't should say that. No, 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 no. Don't let this be like that episode when someone came to my chat and said, Reimu A is the only viable character on Subterranean Animism or Lunatic. Because holy shit. Well, at least in your case, you kinda say it more as something that comes out of unfamiliarity. Damn, I got so triggered when they said viable. Like, the only viable character for Lunatic. Like, what the fuck, dude? The worst part is that it was said by a guy that didn't even play the game. So it makes you wonder, right? Focus when on focus spread. Yeah, but you have fucking 8 bombs. Like, I mean, sure, if you're playing no bomb, it might be far from the best shot you can use. But dude, it has 8 bombs. Let me say it again just in case. 8 bombs. 8 bombs. I don't think any shot type ever in any Touhou game has 8 bombs. Unless obviously you get 8 bombs throughout the game and don't die. But yeah, that doesn't count. Should point at Reimu C. Yeah, Reimu C, sadly, it's a pretty bad shot type. Probably one of the worst. If not the worst. Probably the worst. The bomb kinda suck. Yeah, but I mean, dude, if you had an overpowered bomb and at the same time you have 8 on stock, it's like, you know, you pretty much just install a TIS to beat the game instantly. So switching between the patchy shot types is annoying. Wait. Marisa A? Wait. No, wait a second. Marisa B, isn't Marisa B the patchy one? Yeah, I know, it is Marisa B. Okay, I was about to wonder, because you suddenly mentioned switching between patchy shot types is annoying, I'm like, what? That's not Marisa A. But yeah, I understand what you mean. It might be annoying, but it's the best ranged character in the game. And it's useful and it can trivialize a lot of patterns, especially stage patterns, just because of how good that range is. And also the damage is incredibly decent. The bomb, you know, it's kind of trash, but if you use one bomb to not die and use another bomb to, like, right next to the boss, you might deal pretty good damage. Obviously, you're gonna waste 2 bombs instead of 1, but also, Marisa C, which is the Nitori shot type, is not really that good. Mostly because the thing with that shot type is that the bomb damage is trash, it has a pretty mediocre duration, and your shot has a horrible range and mediocre damage as well. So it's not obviously what I will call a terrible shot type, but I will probably say it's the second worst shot type in the game. Obviously, not below Reimu C. Reimu C definitely should be the worst shot type in the game, probably. Reimu A seems like a strong pick. Yeah, Reimu A is obviously the best shot type in the game, with no contest about it, since you have a bomb that will always deal static damage no matter which part of the screen you're standing on. It has really good damage, decent range, and obviously not to mention that trick where you can teleport from screen to screen, which can make a lot of patterns incredibly trivial, right? So yeah, it has that, and it's pretty cool. Oh, I wonder. Okay, that works. So what's up here? More shit. Okay, but should I? Okay, that works. And for this, it's obviously a full jump. Nice. Is this also a full jump? Yeah. Oh, this jump is pretty evil. Or maybe not that evil. Oh shit, is that a shop? What do you sell? Bargainburg. What boots? I don't see any boots. I see a fucking, whatever this shit is called in English. Yeah, I don't think I carry any gold though, so I will have to decline. Yep. Yeah, it is pretty much at the bare minimum. Any rich friends? Well, I maybe have them, but there are no way that they are gonna come all the way here, that's for sure. Nitori shot has like no white coverage. Yeah, pretty much. How come it's raining on one screen and not above? I'm more concerned about how a guy with full plate armor can jump that high. Feel like that's a bigger concern here, but you know. Is this also a full jump to the left? Yes. I don't think this can be a full jump to the right though. Probably not. Nope. Well, thankfully I only fell here. And most of these are full jumps, which is good. I don't have to think. I can go brain dead against this. This obviously is the exception. This is not a full jump. But I wonder, because it's pretty easy to hit that platform up there, which is obviously a problem, right? So how do I do this? Oh, well, that's an interesting jump. A little bit hard. What does this say? Tone Halbor of Notice. This abandoned town, which is clearly abandoned and which no one lives in, is henceforth irrevocably, eternally, foreverly, uncancellably, and undeniably claimed by right of previous owners. Okay, as the sole proprietary of merchant. What? Meshildus Drig? Alright. Contain unintelligible. Alright. Interesting. Fucking stoner ass. Stoner. Can I do a full jump in here? What happens if I hit my head? Oh, nothing. Alright, good shit. So, I can do that jump, right? Yes. You know, this is one of the parts that I remember. Because as I told you, this is sadly not a blind run. I already seen this game even if I didn't see it fully. But I do remember this part and the part that is next to this one. And holy shit, it has some pretty fucked up stuff, that's for sure. This jump is in fact pretty fucked up as well. I don't think it's a full jump. And it indeed is not a full jump. Yeah, I thought that I wouldn't be able to do that jump, but I wanted to try. Also, speaking of Touhou 11, what is your current objective, Kyle, on that game? I even jump to the left? Maybe that's an achievement or some shit. I don't know. Damn it! I also just realized that you probably can't see this guy. Oh, actually you can. I'm just blocking, well, if you want to know what I'm blocking here, like that thing below that new thing, bulletin or whatever, it's one of those things that is used to play old discs. I don't know the name of that in English, but you know, one of those golden things that have like a big ass speaker. And they have like an arm that plays the discs in that. I know the name in Spanish, but I don't know it in English, so whatever. So a video and only remember the religious building later. Yeah, there is a lot of fucked up bullshit after this section of the game. I mean, this section of the game is already kind of hard. But yeah, there is a lot of even more fucked up bullshit afterwards, so yeah, you can tell that there is a pretty big journey ahead. Though I thought that this was a DLC, but I guess no, this is the main game. Just because apparently this game has two DLCs. I already seen the last one, the one that released not too long ago. I don't think I seen the first one. The first DLC. That might be an actual blind run if I ever play it, that is. Because I really didn't see the first DLC for this game. Yeah, a vinyl player. Yeah, that thing. I just obviously didn't know the name in English. Because, you know, right here we call it Tocadiscos, right? You know, that's Spanish, so it doesn't count. Okay, so this is not a full jump, but... Maybe I can do something like that. Normal SA is harder than normal UFO. Oh, you're looking for normal clear and extra. I see. Well, I definitely, well, obviously, as anyone will tell you, I recommend Reimu A, but you know, you can do with any character you like. Loot name, if you think about it. Yeah, but what would Discos be an euphemism of? Like, well, for those who don't know, disco means disc, though it's a little bit obvious, but... what will that be an euphemism of? I mean, yes, I know it has a hole in the middle, so it can mean an euphemism of that, but I never seen anyone use it as an euphemism for that. Right? Oh, you piece of shit. No! Stop falling, dammit. I do normal without characters. Oh. Damn. No, that's some masochist kind of thing. That's something that I never... I mean... I never tried to beat a Touhou game with only... Like, with all characters in only one difficulty. I mean, I did it in hard with 10 Desires, with Imperishable Knight, and with some games that I just liked them, and I wanted to keep playing them, but... And also to unlock Spellguards, yeah, that's most likely the case, especially on Touhou 8. And also Touhou 7, though Touhou 7... Yeah, you need to play as the different characters to actually unlock the Prims River Sisters Spellguards. Okay, what is this jump about, though? Okay, that's a little bit too high. Fuck. Damn, that was pretty close. That scared me a little bit, because if I fall from there, I'm pretty sure I'm going down, down, down. Really? That didn't count? I will call bullshit on that. How didn't that count? Ouch. Want to experience the pain of other shot types? I usually try to use the shittiest shot types on the lower difficulties and then leave the better shot types for the upper difficulties. Like, for example, Reimu A, I only beat Touhou 11 with Reimu A when on Lunatic, right? Right, basically, my normal one coin clear was with Reimu B. I think I had two hard one coin clears with Marisa A and B. I don't know if I beat the game with Marisa C. I think I beat the game with Reimu C to do a normal no bomb. And then I left Reimu A for Lunati one coin clear. And I did it too. So yeah, I usually do that in order to experience all the shot types in the game. Damn, that jump is so fucking hard. Holy shit. That might be the hardest jump yet. Though at least, if you fail the jump, the punishment is not that big. So at least, I guess that doesn't make it that hard of a jump. Okay, that was complete horseshit, however. Okay, that wasn't horseshit. That was me being a dumbass. That fucking sucks. Oh, that really sucks. Well. Interesting. I guess that was just a matter of time. I tried Reimu A in SA, but did better with Marisa B. Yeah, Marisa B is a pretty good character, honestly. Can be good no matter your, like, you know, your skill level. Marisa B is an amazing shot. But the same can be said about Reimu A. Reimu A, no matter how good or bad you are, it's probably the best shot you can choose by a long shot. Like, if you want to just do survival and you just want to pick the best character possible, then there is no reason to pick anyone other than Reimu A. But obviously, that doesn't mean that any other character is not viable. Yes, I'm gonna keep repeating that because it triggered me so much that I still remember it to this day. Fucking not viable. Said it was not viable. The nerve. The nerve of saying it's not viable. Damn, we got here a lot faster than I expected, thankfully. Nice, good shit. So I was gonna take a lot more, a lot longer, I mean. Hey, Balabis, how is it going? You know, don't mind me, just playing a game that is probably gonna reduce my lifespan by a couple years. But you know, just playing Touhou, by default, you get a reduced lifespan for sure, so don't worry about it. Also, how the fuck do you do this jump? There has to be... Like, what happens if I do it from here? Okay, so you can do it from the very limit and do a medium jump and it works. Now, the problem is that that jump is followed by also another really hard jump, which is this one. This jump is... It's really hard. So it can be high, like it can be high enough, but if I don't do it high enough, I don't think I can reach the other side, right? That's my problem with that. Okay, that seems to be too short. Nice. Dude can only jump indeed. This dude wants to become the jump king. So the only controls, the only buttons in this game are literally left, right, jump. That's all the buttons that are available in this game. Nothing else, nothing more, nothing else, pretty much. One of those. I hate it when that happens. It's kind of like the little guy gets displaced into... Yeah, you can't even steer in air. Like, you have to jump on an arc, on a static arc. Obviously, you control the strength of the jumps, but that's about it. That's the only thing you control in the game. In any other field, it's the game, the one that controls you. That jump fucking sucks, alright? Let me tell you that. And honestly, that's the first jump that I feel like it alright sucks. Cause you know, they were hard jumps before, but I feel like that one is just bad. Cause a lot of times it really feels like you're getting in there, but it's just displacing you into falling through the edges. No OST. There is OST, but it only gets here when you go higher. Like, basically, when you are on the lower levels, you have, like, this atmosphere of no music at all. So, yeah, you sadly have to deal with that. Until you get to the higher parts of the game. Is this getting over it too? Yeah, it is indeed. How is it going, folks? Now, I'm obviously just kidding. This is a game that is pretty similar in getting over it, in the sense that you're probably gonna want to kill something when you finish playing it, but yeah, it's still not quite the same. How do I do this? I don't think I can wall bounce. Can I? Well, maybe I can. Damn, you're actually supposed to wall jump there. Okay. So I'm assuming that this is a really short jump, right? Yeah. And then also a pretty short jump here. Pretty sure this is a wall bounce. What about this? Is this also that? Probably. Oh, this is bad. Can I do... Oh, nice. Pent up personal anxiety and stress getting to me. Well, thankfully you're not playing this game, because if you were, this will definitely get into you more easily. Oh, shit. Okay. No. Bueno. That's fine. That's fine. I mean, could have been worse. Could have been way worse. But the good thing is that once you get out of this part, the only way you can fall down here is when you are really up there. And there is a specific part that is really, like, really, you know, evil, where you can fall all the way down here. But for the most part, if I get past this section, there should be a more or less safe section afterwards. So that's cool. It's a good incentive. Hey, Feather, how is it going? Yeah, this game is pretty nice. It definitely doesn't make you want to cut your head off or anything like that. No, no, it's a really good game, right? I'm pretty sure I'm supposed to go left. Like, what will happen if I go right? Nothing, right? No, this is probably like a shelter if you fall. Now, the problem is, how do I jump to the left? Probably not a full jump. Yeah, something like that. Maybe this is supposed to be a full jump. From here? Yeah. What's up here, though? Is this supposed to be... Yeah. The Great Frontier! The Great Frontier. Not just any frontier. This one is great. Alright. Good to know. Was about to fear that this might be the mediocre frontier. But no, this is the Great Frontier. Also, no. This is not the checkpoint that I was thinking of. Sadly, here you need to go to the right. You can't jump from here. Well, that kind of sucks, but that's fine. And this jump is pretty suspicious. Because I'm pretty sure I'm supposed to jump to that other pillar right there. I don't think I can do a direct jump from here, which... Okay, but I can do that. Nice. Oh, alright. Damn it. Okay, this is not full jump. This is full jump. This is also full jump. But these are not. Nice. God damn it. I mean, this is really stressful, I gotta tell ya. And you know, me being a person that has vertigo doesn't help. I mean, obviously, if this was a 3D game, it would be worse, but... Yeah, it's a little bit scary too, even being 2D. Imagine speedrunning this game. Well, I mean... That's something that might not be as hard as you think. Speedrunning this game is mostly... I mean, I'm not a speedrunner and I'm not gonna be a speedrunner either. But I don't think speedrunning this game is hard, because once you memorize every single... Yeah, I mean, the hardest part is memorizing, but if you memorize every single champ, I don't think execution is that big of a barrier. Obviously, the problem is the nerves. That's the biggest problem, just like in any speedrun, but... Once you memorize every single champ, because every champ is static, there is no RNG in here. And there is also not that much physics going on. So, once you figure out every single champ and memorize them, it's all a matter of not getting nervous. Which, again, it's obviously the hardest part, because getting nervous in games like this is extremely common. Also, this is a weird champ. Don't think I quite get it. I don't think I'm supposed to jump into that little thing there, because if I do that, I don't think I can jump anywhere else. So I think this should be a full jump. Full jump to the left, obviously. The problem here is that I need to get into that tiny ass pillar. He has a vertigo, point at him and laughed. Yeah, I'm one of those people that is afraid of hate. Well, that's the definition of vertigo, right? Because I know that's the definition of vertigo in Spanish, but I don't know if English is the same meaning. I think it has the same meaning, right? Like, fear of hate. Pretty sure it's the same. There are speedruns already. Yeah, of course there are speedruns already. The speedrun community hardly sleeps. Hates don't kill, the fall does. Damn, getting philosophical in here. Is this also supposed to be a full jump? Well, I mean... Oh, the... Yeah, the real problem is jumping from here. Can you even do that? Well, I don't know if you can do that, but... Not like that. Like, if you do it, you don't do it like that. That's what we know. Too much strength on that jump. Yeah, I know, right? This jump is already incredibly hard. I know it doesn't look that hard. But yeah, this jump where you have to land on that fucking little ass column. That isn't even a column. It's too thin to even be considered a column. But yeah, that jump is atrocious. And that one is probably not even supposed to be a full jump. But how do I get there if it's not? Or a better question is, how do I get it from here? The good thing is that the only way you can fail this jump is by doing a full jump. But I don't even know if I'm supposed to jump from here. Probably not, now that I think about it. I think this jump might indeed be impossible from here. You probably need to do it from the left. Though, it obviously is pretty tempting because it feels possible. But... Okay, it is possible, never mind. Oh, this is starting to look even more scary. I mean, it already looked scary before, but... Damn, holy shit. Want to give me a heart attack? There's not much you can do on this one. Fuck. I mean, not like I was not expecting it. That was pretty expected, but still. And this fucking asshole laughing. Just like that. I'm gonna get you tomorrow. I'm gonna give you an issue that you're not gonna be able to solve, and then I want your ass crying back to me saying, no, please, Gabby, help me solve this. But no, I'm gonna be like, huh? If you can beat Shumpkin, I'm gonna help you. What about that? Fuck. Well, at least that fall. This fall is not that bad. No, this fall. Yeah, that one might be bad. Well, it's not even that bad. If you land there, the only thing you need to... Well, it's bad because of this one. Doing this one again is a pain in the ass. But other than that, it's not that bad. And the problem of, you know, retrying this like that it's pretty easy to tilt. Because if you do the same jump over and over again in a short amount of time, a short period of time, right? It's pretty easy to fuck up. Pretty easy. So sometimes you gotta wait, take a breath, take a deep breath, and be like, alright, let's think this peacefully. Let's think about this without any hurry. But you know, sometimes even when you think it without hurry, you still fail. But that's fine, because failing... I mean, this game is all about failing. You know, there is that pretty popular saying that says it doesn't matter how many times you fall, but how many times you stand up. Or something like that. Well, this game is literally that. It's not about how many times you fall, but how many times you don't rage quit. Love is in Spanish. Yeah. But you know, he has not many options, because he really doesn't know English that much. And in fact, he doesn't even understand what I'm saying right now, so I probably can talk shit about him while he's listening and he won't understand that I'm talking shit. But you know, I'm obviously not an asshole to do that, so... But yeah. Back to the... Damn, what a... Ah, yummy. You know, one of these days... Yeah, he's my coworker. He is. It's one of my coworkers. One of my coworkers that is still working at the same company. Because, you know, as I told you before, most of my other coworkers just left the company, right? I guess I was too much of a weeb for them, so they were like, nah, I'm not dealing with this guy, so they have to leave. But, you know, when it comes to this guy, yeah, this guy is still there. Damn, everyone here wants to see me reach the bottom, huh? I'm gonna reach the bottom, yes. I'm gonna reach the bottom of your asses. That's what I'm gonna reach. And then you're gonna beg that you didn't write that. Then you're gonna be like, please, we didn't mean it. It's gonna be too late. It's gonna be too late. I'm gonna be so deep that I wouldn't even be able to pull it out. Okay, before this gets any more homosexual, let's leave the conversation for a bit, right? The FX, do you have any problem with my FX? You know, this FX is my first decent processor. Because I'm pretty sure... I don't even remember what processor I had before this. I think it was a sorry-ass stock processor from Hewlett-Packard. So, you know, you can tell that I probably had a pretty sorry-ass processor. I honestly don't even remember which one it was. But I do remember it being a bottleneck. The only one indenture here is me, because I'm near Gabi geographically. That's right. I could take a bus or whatever get to where Kyle is and prepare the lube. Ah, fuck. It feels like it really is pretty possible to do that from there, but at the same time it feels like it's incredibly hard. Well, nice jump. Good jump. Oh, I have to do this fucking jump again. Oh, okay. First try. Don't worry about it. Oh, damn, that fucking emote is so fitting for this playthrough. Holy shit. It really is pretty fitting for this playthrough indeed. No! The funniest part about this game is how the character falls head first to the ground. Like, he doesn't even fall with his hands there. No, head first. I don't know how this character is not more brain dead than me by this point, right? Like, he must have a pretty high quality helmet. That's for sure. That's what the armor is for. You know, the funny thing is that if the armor was actually, you know, it follow real life physics, the armor will be the actual thing that will kill him instantly. As you know, when you fall from a pretty high height, there is some probability that you might survive, even though you're probably gonna not be able to walk again. But if you wear a heavy armor like that, it's fucking over. You're fucking dead. Like, any minimum height that you fall from with that armor, you're fucking dead. Like, there's no way you survive. Hey, will you be able to? There we go, thanks. Well, that's a pretty nice fall. It almost was calculated. Yeah, that fall. That, like, if every other fall hurt, that one, you fall head first into a pole. Yeah. Good luck with that. I wonder how the fuck I'm supposed to do this jump. Well, yeah, like that. That's how you do it. Still a pretty hard jump. Wait. Is that Otto from Street Fighter? Cause that looks like Otto from Street Fighter 3. Copyright? What about the copyright? I will wait here. Well, now the problem is that by doing this sham, I actually completely corner myself. Or not. Because you're obviously supposed to go full shump to the left like that. I wonder about this one. Should I wall? Okay, we probably have to think this a little bit. No, I don't think we're supposed to go to the left here. That wouldn't accomplish anything. I'm pretty sure we're supposed to go to the right. Damn, that shump to the pole there is gonna be a piece of shit. Then from there a full jump to the left, and then well, that one is also gonna be a piece of shit. Looks like Valkyrie armor or Heihachi. No, he definitely looks like Otto from Street Fighter. Like, if you don't know him, look it up. Otto Street Fighter 3. He definitely looks like Otto. Oh. Well. Now, the real question is this a full jump or not? It is. It is a full jump. Now, the problem here is that this is obviously not a full jump. So, this has to be an insanely precise jump. Like, holy shit, this jump is incredibly precise. This looks fun. It looks pretty fun, indeed. Alright, I actually got it. So, yeah, I'm probably supposed to go to the right. Windswept Bluff? No! No, you can't be this evil. Well, I guess I see what that monk means now. It's a pretty interesting fuck. Well, I didn't even know where to jump there, by the way. Nice. Nice. Prepare your ass. Yep. Oh, well. Seems like we keep going down, down, down. Good shit. Really like it when we get to see the whole game again like this. That's the good thing. You get to see the game again. If you didn't see it before, you can see it again. It's pretty cool, right? Should have listened to the monk. Yeah. Fucking monks are always right. Well, that is a full jump. That, however, is not a full jump. Nice! What an amazing jump that was. That one was even better. So I wonder how far we can get. How far down we can get, that is, obviously. What you were thinking, I was thinking about how far up we can get. Nah. It's about how close to the bottom we can reach. Oh, and trust me, we can definitely reach. Really, really down into the bottom. I like the big ass smile on that asshole. Really? Get a jump from the very tip. Oh, that can be a full jump. Interesting. No, that's too short. Fuck. I really wonder, maybe I'm confusing it with the DLC, but I do remember after that snowy shit, there was a place that looked a lot like a checkpoint. But maybe I'm wrong. It's That jump fucking sucks. Nice! The only checkpoint is the bottom. Damn it, Kyle, repeating my words. But you're not wrong, though. But yeah. But you know, as I said before, the good thing with this game is that, differently from Getting Over It, you know, Getting Over It had pretty shitty controls, to me at least. I know that some people don't mind the controls, but to me they were a complete piece of trash. Well, speaking of piece of trash. So, you know, the problem with that is that not only it was frustrating to lose progress, but it was also frustrating to play. Now, this game, it might be frustrating to play, but at least the controls are not trash. In fact, they are incredibly straightforward. Probably the most straightforward controls that I've seen in a long time, right? Maybe the only thing that might not be that obvious for someone who just starts playing is the fact that the wall, you know, the wall jump, I don't even know if I should call it wall jump, but like, you know, when you hit the wall to bounce, the wall bounce, let's call it the wall bounce. That might not be obvious to someone that it's actually necessary in order to progress, but, you know, other than that, the controls here are incredibly straightforward. Obviously, that doesn't mean that the game is easy. In fact, very far from it. But you know, whatever, right? I guess masochism really makes people do some weird shit. In this case, playing this game. The good thing is that once you get more and more used with the jumps, you start really memorizing them like this. Well, yeah, that was a pretty nice shins, but damn. So I got shins myself. Good shit. Good shins, I should say. Nice. See, that's why you don't want to take things for granted. Because that's what happens if you do. That's absolutely what happens. The problem here, again, as I also mentioned before, is that unless I'm in the very last section of the game, there is gonna be no fucking music at all. But the problem is that if I put my own music, not only most of them are gonna be copyrighted as fuck, but even if that wasn't an issue, the real issue is that, you know, nobody really wants to listen to other people's shit, right? So if I put some music, it's gonna be hard to place everyone. Yeah, I thought about Toho OST, but I will need... See, here's the problem about Toho OST. Most of the lists on YouTube include the extended version of Toho themes. And if you're gonna do a playlist, you don't wanna use the extended version, right? You don't want to listen to the same song for 10 minutes before changing to the next song. Because that's not how playlists work. So, you know, that's a big problem. And also, you know, YouTube being trash doesn't help. Maybe instead of doing that, I should probably download them to my computer and play them from here. But that will take a lot of work to do. I mean, it's not like it's hard to do, it's just that it's gonna take time that I don't have or that I don't wanna use. I like listening to other people's stuff because it allows me to find new things. I don't know. I mean, it's nice if someone suggests you to listen to something, right? And you can choose, you know, choose if you want to listen to it or not. But the problem is that when you have no choice. So, for example, here, if I put my own music, you can't do shit about it. Like, I mean, unless you mute the stream, you have no other option but to listen to it. And I know that that sucks for a lot of people. So yeah, that will be the issue here. Ah, damn it. Just Google them in Japanese, those aren't extended, and don't touch the Flanders Whole World channels. No, I know. That's basically where all the extended soundtracks come from. But I don't know, I will think about it. Because I thought that this game had music more often, but it seems like it doesn't have shit. Like, it doesn't have shit until you reach the very last levels, which fucking sucks. Well, I mean, you can call that a piece of music, but not really. Because it stops the moment you leave this screen. Nice. That's even better. No, that's even better. Well, seems that we're reaching the bottom. Indeed. Look at this beautiful tree. Almost missed the tree. Well, not like I didn't expect it to happen, but it's pretty sad to see it, right? Like, you hate to see it. But you know, it was to be expected. It's not really a surprise. It was about to happen sooner or later. And as I mentioned before, it's the quicksand effect. You start falling, and it's pretty hard to stop falling. Because it's mistake after mistake, especially after you build muscle memory for the higher jumps. When you come back to the lower jumps, it's pretty hard to remember how they were. So you kind of have to not only remember them, but also have enough muscle memory to remember them, right? Okay, it seems like we're going straight. Yeah, let's go straight to the bottom, alright? I mean, I already got the theme for the PTSD. Shunko's theme, so you can be glad this isn't PDH. No, I'd rather this be PDH. You know, as much as I hate PDH, this is way more, this is way more of a torture than PDH can ever dream to be. So, you know. Maybe I could do some song requests, but no, that fucking sucks. Because that will mean that I have to listen to your shit. And, you know. I mean, I know a lot of you listen usually to things that I also listen to, but yeah. And also, I will have to moderate that. Like, if someone decides to be an asshole and links some non-safe for work YouTube video with moans or whatever, yeah, I will have to, you know, basically spare my attention for that. So that sucks. This PDH can delete your one coin clears if you lose. Well, PDH can't, but a bug in that game can. I think that if your game crashes during a point device mode run, I think your save might get fucked up. So it might not be PDH itself, but it's definitely gonna be something else. People spam Snoop Dogg. Honestly, I don't think Snoop Dogg can get my stream banned. I know that I like to joke about it, especially because, you know, Snoop Dogg and a lot of rappers obviously love to use the N-word, because why would they not? I mean, there is no reason not to use it. I mean, after all, as people like to say, although I disagree with this, it's their word, right? I obviously disagree with that because I think it's a word that everyone should be able to use, especially if it's not in a racist context. But whatever. If I argue about that, I might actually get banned there. But yeah, what I'm trying to say here is that I don't really think I can get banned for listening to Snoop Dogg or any other rapper that likes to throw the N-word as if it was candies. I mean, what I probably will need to do, however, is mark the stream as adults only. And I honestly don't have any problem doing that. Because I don't want any kids. I mean, I already had to deal with kids, and it's a fucking pain in the ass. So yeah, that, well, I mean, that also won't get rid of, you know, of kids, because it's literally one click away. They just have to be, this contest is only for adults. Okay, and they just get access to the stream, but yeah. In any case, 10 hours soft low libre. Wow. That's another Kyle comment of the hour. I didn't expect anything less than that. Anything less than that would have not been a Kyle comment. Now, that's also a problem. You know, if I listen to a Snoop Dogg or whatever other rapper, the problem is that I might want to start singing along, right? And if I sing along while they say that word, then I can get in trouble. That's the problem. You know, today in Discord I link a Snoop Dogg song that is called Bato, I think. Basically the chorus for that song, like, it has the N-word like 6 times. So, you can't avoid it. It's literally there. But I like the song. It's not like I listen to it just because I want to make fun of it or anything like that. No. I legitimately enjoy the song. I like it. But sadly, apparently liking that, and in consequence singing along, can probably be enough to label me as racist. And I don't want to deal with any of that shit, honestly. So yeah, it's sadly a sensitive topic. In my music library, I have a song that is literally a wow. God damn it, Kyle. Yeah, you never fail to make me proud. You never fail to make me proud. Every time I think you can be more degenerate, you always appear there and you're like, no, I can, trust me. Watch this, right? God damn it, Kyle. I shamed there, god damn it, fuck. That the rabbit hole goes deeper. Well, as long as it doesn't go deep enough to actually get you into legal trouble, that's fine by me. I mean, as long as your rabbit hole only goes down to legal degeneracy, that's fine to me. But you know, I wouldn't know. My race and hold. God damn it. I only saw my if only you saw my favorites on BitSiv. Yeah, that's pretty interesting. I usually try not to use my BitSiv account precisely because of that. But I feel like I should start using BitSiv more. Cause I know, like, I used BitSiv in the past to you know, search for wallpapers and all that shit. And it's really useful, right? But the problem is that, you know, obviously BitSiv allows all kind of content, so you can find some stuff that obviously it gets saved onto your preferences, right? So next time you search for wallpapers, it might not be as clean as it used to be. BitSiv has every fetish you could dream of. Well, yeah, pretty much. But yeah, I probably should start using it more. Also, goddammit, I haven't been able to get out of these fucking sewers in what it feels like forever. Yes, I know it hasn't been like even 20 minutes yet, but still. I think I even make people like me sick at times. Well, the problem here, you have to disable the Guro tag. Come on, dude. Well, no, actually no, because I think you are also into that. So I can't even. Oh, never mind. You know what? Disregard what I should say. When one of the sets I click on was all mine, yaoi. Well, that's not bad. I mean, obviously, it's not like I will enjoy it. I wouldn't say it's fucked up or anything like that. I thought you mean truly fucked up stuff. But you know, coming from a guy that likes boar, I don't think you will be sickened by anything that I will mention, so don't worry about it. Although I still, you know, boar is one of those fetishes that I really can't understand yet. Yet. Maybe at some point I'm gonna understand it, but not yet. I definitely have not been able to understand it yet. Fuck, why am I hitting my head on that one? That's like the third time in a row that I hit my head on that ceiling. It didn't happen before. Maybe that jump is a lot shorter than I'm expecting it to be. Yeah, it's a little bit shorter. Oh, that's not a full jump. Be careful about that. This is a full jump, and this is also a full jump. This is not, and this is obviously not a full jump. At least we're back in the fucking house. Even I have my standards. Most Borari poorly done, you really need to dig to find the shems. Oh, is poorly done. I was about to ask them, not only you enjoy it, but you also make it. Like a true degenerate, but no, never mind. But yeah, I don't know. It's a little bit. Well, if you don't mind linking, and when I say linking, I don't mean literally linking. You know what I mean by linking. One of them in Discord, then I can check them out and see if I can understand it. obviously for out of curiosity, right? Nothing else. You can access Sad Panda. The fuck is Sad Panda? Is that a webpage? With that name, I don't know if I want to have access to that. Oh. I don't know if I have access or not. I will have to see. I mean, I have no clue. Don't even know why I wouldn't have access in the first place, but... Team, that jump almost fucked me up. Well, the good thing is that we are out of the sewers and we're into Bargainburg. You need an account? Well, in that case, they can fuck right off. Nah, I'm not gonna make an account. But I'm pretty sure that if you search for it, you can find it somewhere else, right? It will be pretty hard for me to think that it's only on that page, right? Oh, I tried to jump right, it's left. Too weak. So the Library of Babel for Ditions. Damn. Kyle knows his shit, alright? But yeah, I mean, my limit is definitely creating an account. I obviously created an account of on Pitsy because, as I told you, I browse for wallpapers. And I mean safe wallpapers. So I obviously don't have any problem with that. But creating an account on one of those sites? Nah, dude. I'm fine. I'm fine without that. They are safe. I mean, I can probably zip my whole wallpaper collection and there's not a single non-safe for work wallpaper at all. Because usually those kind of pictures, I don't save them into my computer because I don't feel like there's any reason to save them. Nice. Well, I will say that we are back in business, but that's not quite true. We still haven't reached the Ice Mountain, which is pretty much where we should be going to. So we are about to reach there. This is gonna take a little bit more. Oh, I forgot. This is supposed to be like that. There we go. Alright, so this is a risky one. Because of that, it's a risky one. Ah, that one needs a lot more power. God damn it. Fuck that. But yeah, my wallpapers are 100% family friendly. Well, although lately I don't even use the wallpapers that I have because I use Wallpaper Enshine to have wallpapers. And no, I also don't have any non-safe for work wallpaper enshines as well, right? Though, I've seen a lot of them, and a lot of them are pretty good. I always mention the same one, but there is one wallpaper on Wallpaper Enshine that has Yukari and Yuyuko. and something in the middle that you can probably guess what it is. And they are both going, whatever. I don't want to enter into detail because this is a family-friendly stream. But you can probably imagine it. I don't think I need to explain any further. See? Yannick gets it. A gap? No! Actually, there's no gap. There is, let's call it an exactly, I was about to say, Demi, what a fucking dictionary. I was about to say that word. Yes, an umbrella. Let's say an umbrella. Damn, I can't believe. See, that's the kind of thing that makes you understand how Kyle and me are like twin souls when it comes to the degeneracy. We understand ourselves perfectly. I don't know if that's a good or a bad thing, but yeah. Exactly. Let's just say that there is an umbrella in the middle, and Yuyuko and Yukari are at the sides. And obviously they are moving, because it's an animated wallpaper. That's the whole point of Wallpaper Enshine. And yeah, it's pretty good. Sadly it was deleted, but I do remember it. Definitely remember it. I mean, it's pretty hard to forget something like that after all. How the fuck did you do this jump again? Okay, not like that. You don't do it like that. Fuck. At least that platform there, it's like a pretty... like a mini checkpoint, right? Unless you fall from a pretty... like from a weird angle. Most of the times you're gonna fall into that platform, which is great. Gotcha. Alright, so I guess now we're back in business. I don't know for how long, but we're definitely back in business. This is my problem. This jump is so unbelievably hard. And it's so punishing as well. If you fail this jump, you're pretty much going down. I don't really know how to do it in a reliable way. Like, I mean, you obviously can see me doing it, but... it's so hard to replicate, right? It. I always feel like if I hold the jump button for too long on this jump, I'm gonna regret it. But if you don't hold it for long, you just bounce off. I almost got it there. Nice. Oh, interesting. Yeah, that happened before too. It's really great when that happens. I think the trick to that jump that I just did is doing it from either the middle or the right side of the lower platform. If you do that, it shouldn't be that bad. But you know. Obviously, though all of those jumps are incredibly risky to do. Not a single one of them is safe. Okay. No. God damn it. There we go. That's too damn high, god. Yeah, sections like those that only have, like, solitary platforms like this, they are really hard. Because obviously, once you fail one jump, you're really going down a lot. The worst part is that, remember that the next section after this has wind. It has fucking wind. Oh, that's not where you wanna go. You wanna go the other side. Okay, this was not a full jump, yes. But this one, fuck. Okay, at least for the most part you're not gonna fall to the bottom from there. But okay. Calm down. Well, seems like we can keep getting into the bottom. Fuck, dude. Nice! Oh, well, that's a good place to land. It's actually a good place to land. That's not a good place to land, however. Are you serious? I never failed that jump so much before. What the fuck, dude? Why am I failing it now? Tilted? Yeah, pretty much. Am I supposed to? No, because if I do a full jump, that's gonna happen. So what kind of jump are you even? Well, let's say that it's a pretty precise one. But at least, if you fuck up, you don't fall. Well, if you don't fuck up too bad, you don't fall. Let me stretch a little bit, because you know, it might not look like it, but doing this over and over again, it gets pretty tiresome. Gets a little bit tiresome, so you kinda need to stretch. Stretch, not stretch. I don't even know what stretch is. Go, Gabby. Yeah, go to the bottom. I know. Don't worry, it's gonna happen. Maybe. Maybe not. Who knows? Nice. Really, dude? Come on. Oh, you can do the jump like that. It has to be really precise. Like, really precise. That's obviously a problem. That one in particular has to be insanely precise. Holy fuck, dude. But yeah, I think that after seeing that section with the wind... That might be it. I don't think I can do that section with the wind. It's already hard to figure out what jump I should exactly do without wind. Imagine how hard it's gonna be with variable wind. That jump seems like speedrunner's nightmare. Seems like it is. Do a Remelia stretch. I don't know how to interpret that. A Remelia stretch? Is that from that doujin you mentioned? Or is that something that... A safe for work reference that I didn't get? It's totally safe for work, damn. I'm surprised, especially coming from you. One of her spell cards in Soku? Interesting. No, it's not the right, dumbass, it's the left. Fuck. How was that a long jump? God damn it, fucking piece of shit. Okay. Okay, calm down. We can get through this. Basically, she stretches a lot and makes a giant slash with her claws. It's damn slow but unblockable. So is it like Slayer's Unblockable, where he basically does something like that and it's really slow but it's literally unblockable? Well, I mean, Remilius is a vampire after all, so having a Slayer reference will only be natural. No, not the right, goddammit. Well, thankfully, if you jump to the right, you don't die. I mean, you don't fall, you can die in this game. I mean, your motivation can die, but your character cannot. Not humanly possible, I know, right? Well, I don't think my character is a human, so I think I will be fine. Also, it's pretty funny, because I'm pretty sure I did this jump on the first try. But, okay, I did it here too. But this shit, dude, this shit is so fucked up. So basically, doing a neutral jump can move you too. So I'm supposed to do a full neutral jump here. Damn, and it moves you a lot. It doesn't just move you a little bit. It moves you quite a lot. Stormwall pass, and you cannot walk. In case you didn't know, you cannot walk in this snow. You can only jump. It's impossible to walk. Oh, wow. I don't know what to say. Yeah, literally, the only thing you can do is jumping. Can't do anything else. Also, what the fuck is that thing right there? What kind of monster is that supposed to be? Okay, at least I got here. Though the problem is that I don't know what's up there. Okay, that's up there. Covers almost the whole screen, damn. Along with the board, damn it. I'm playing into your narrative, Gabby. I'm not actually cruel. Yeah, sure. And I'm definitely not a Toho fanboy at all. And I don't like newest legs at all. Yeah, sure. Sure. Why not? Okay, so I'm assuming that here can do short jumps and then a full one? Yes. Damn, this is gonna be a pretty slow and pretty fucked up section. At least I can walk on that one up there, though. I don't know why I will need to walk. I don't think there is any reason to walk in a section like this. Other than, well, you know, kind of positioning yourself. Maybe they want you to position yourself here because this is going to be a fucked up jump. Am I supposed to do a full jump while the wine is against me? Or am I supposed to... Okay, not that one. Well, thankfully that fall wasn't that bad. Maybe I am supposed to jump here. No, the wind is like a lot stronger than you can imagine. God damn it. I mean, you can jump against the wind, but it's probably a pretty bad idea. Though I guess if I do a short jump and I clash with the wall, this shouldn't be a problem. Yeah, it shouldn't. Now I'm obviously probably supposed to do a full jump with the wind to the right. Okay, so I get it. You are supposed to get to the upper platform there if you want to do that jump. Okay, sure. I mean, I can do that. Though, being able to do that doesn't mean that it's gonna be easy, obviously. In fact, it's gonna be pretty far from it. So once you get here... The problem is that if I do an overly big jump, that's gonna fucking suck. Oh, never mind, there we go. So now that I'm here, I can do a full jump to the right. And what are these assholes? Are these gargoyles? I will jump to try to talk, but... Damn, man, that jump looks like a fucking nightmare. Actually, all of the jumps here look at like a fucking nightmare. Holy shit. Like, that looks especially evil. I wonder how to do it. I mean, it's obviously pretty precise, and I'm pretty sure it's a full jump as well. Let's see. Okay, no, it has to be a little bit closer. Maybe around here. Okay. Maybe when the wind is in full force. Yeah, like that. And here... Damn, what a fucking asshole. God damn it. Can't say I didn't expect anything else. But, yeah. Alright, so the worst part of that jump is that it's not a full jump with the wind on your favor. Because if you do that, that's what's gonna happen. And you don't want that to happen. Damn it. I don't even know if the place that I remember that was after this is something that I seen or not. Maybe I didn't seen it yet. Have no way of knowing other than actually being there. Maybe, can I? Yeah, that's probably not a good idea to do. I wish the wind didn't last that long though. That would be great. Damn it. And really, the lack of music is... It's really noticeable. Especially in places like this that you're supposed to wait. Like, you can instantly notice how the lack of music starts affecting your brain. Or whatever is left of your brain, that is. If there even is anything left. No. Well, the good thing is that I expected this wind section to be way harder than it is. And I mean, trust me, it is hard, but it's not as hard as I thought it would be. Sadly, that fall at the right is gonna be incredibly annoying. You found the edition stuff I wanted. Alright. Well, you know what to do. In Discord, that is. Posting the secret numbers. Nice. Thanks. I will check it out. Not now, obviously. Because right now, the only bore I'm seeing is the game The Boring My Soul. I tried to do another full jump, but I thought that by being farther from it, it will work. But I was wrong, it doesn't work. Can I do a full jump from here? No, it's not enough. Okay, good to know. Damn it. Also, the thing about this part of the game is that if you do... Oh, come on, that was a legit jump. You can't tell me that was a bad jump. That was a perfect jump. That was a perfect jump, but it still wasn't enough. This... Jump King fucking asshole. Okay. Good thing is that... At the very least... You can let the wind, or the wind, sorry. You can let the wind... guide you. Dude, I don't know how to make that fucking jump. I'm failing in every way possible to do that jump. I really don't know what to do. Fuck. I mean, it's pretty clear that it has to be a jump that you need to do while the wind is on your... Well, the wind, sorry. The wind is on your favor. I understand that, but even knowing that... It's not really enough. Full jump and match win. Yeah, I know it's too much, but if you... Like, I didn't try a full jump there. On my previous attempt, that wasn't a full jump. So that's the fucked up thing. It has to be really precise. Maybe what I can try doing, though, is doing a full jump, but do it at the end of the wind. So I don't get as fucked. So let's see. Like, if I just wait... Oh, I have to wait more than that. Fucker. I'm surprised that these gargoyles or whatever they are supposed to be are not talking. Maybe here? I really love that jump. I love that jump even more. Well, the dream is dead. Those statues give bad luck. Seems like the wind always lasts for 5 seconds. Yeah, seems like my patience also lasts for 5 seconds. Which is not a good thing. Though at least, except for that fucking jump, everything else in this place looks pretty safe. Safe as in, you know, you are most likely not gonna fall. Though I should fail, but I fell because of that fucking jump. And because I got a little bit, you know, in a hurry to do it, but... It doesn't seem like it's the kind of place where it's easy to fall yet. A special emphasis on yet. There is gonna be a time where that's not gonna be the case and we're gonna get fucked. But that time has not arrived yet. Thankfully. Also, I wonder this section, how it will be for speedrunners. I don't think it will be that big of a deal, because they will probably have, you know, all of these strats to make sure they can do this section without that much trouble. Okay, there we go. So I'm assuming this is a full jump to the left from here. It is a full jump to the left. Ah, that looks hard. Fuck you. I told you that looked hard. God damn it. So there's even a harder sham. I thought that I was reaching the end of this wind part, but I guess not. I guess you don't reach the end here. Not yet, at least. A bad idea. But if I want to replicate that shunt, the problem is that I gotta land right at the tip of this thing. And doing that, it's really hard. It's really hard to land right at the right edge of that platform. It's just incredibly hard. See, that's not enough for that. That's too much. God damn it. But I feel like if I do it, like if I do it with a little bit less strength, the issue right there is gonna be that I might not be high enough. Which is obviously a problem. And I gotta be honest that I don't remember seeing this part on any playthrough I've seen. Maybe I might remember what follows after this. I don't know. Maybe not. But I honestly am not sure. Fuck, I didn't mean to do that. I really want to know what happens if I go left here instead of right, but probably nothing good is gonna happen if I do that. Damn, it's incredible how much you hit the wall there. Like, you hit the wall with such force that it's almost impossible to recover back to the platform. Like, the bounce is so damn strong. That's the reason why I feel like I should wait until the wind gets a little bit more calm. But that's also hard to time. I know that you saved 5 seconds. I understand that. But it's pretty hard to count to 5 seconds, that is. It's not hard to count to 5 unless you are in elementary school. But well, if you do a full jump there, you might not fall, but okay, so it works, kinda. If you jump when it's about to end, you can't count to 5 if you are a South American player. What you mean? Are you saying power reach on? You mean S.A. as in subterranean animism. I thought you mean South American. I was about to say, what? I was about to post a come on brew on chat. But thankfully, that wasn't necessary. Also, yes, we're back down here because why the fuck not? Yeah, I know, right? No, I was about to say them, but you're South American too, you know? But no, I then realized my mistake. Okay. This part still sucks, by the way. So it's basically just wait for it, wait. There? Yeah, there. It's hard to time, but you can definitely time it. I still don't know how to do this part, though. This part just looks like a complete pain in the ass to do. Okay, that works. Surprisingly, that doesn't. Okay, at least I only fell here. No, I don't think I can jump that. God damn it. No, I waited too much there. Brain is running low on low power consumption. I mean, do you blame me for that? I've been playing this shit for almost 3 hours. It's pretty hard not to run on low consumption mode. Especially when there is not even... Yeah, you definitely can blame me for running on low consumption mode. Am I gonna get stuck in this snowstorm forever? Is this how it's gonna be? Seems like it is. Really seems like that's gonna be the case. And this jump is so ass. It's so ass, and not the good kind of ass. Yeah, the monk was right. Always trust the monks. The monks know better than you, yes. Where is the stoner that says player skill issue? Oh, it's right there, don't worry. Come on, Yami, where are you? Kyle is calling for you. I mean... this shit is so fucking fucked up. That jump to the right is just fucking trash. Textbook PSI. More like textbook PTSD. Cause that's what I'm gonna get every time I see a snowstorm from now on. What if I jump when the storm ends? Okay, that's a better prompt. Jump right where the storm ends. Like from left to right. That's a good prompt. Okay. So for this one it's just... oh, it's not a full jump. Interesting. Well, that sucks. So hard to fucking position your character, damn it. When all you can do to position yourself is fucking jumping. Yeah, when the storm ends, that's when you gotta start jumping. Well, good to know. That's a pretty good piece of information, I gotta say. That was a way shorter jump than that. Damn it. That sound. I don't think I should jump from here. I think I need a little bit more space to the... to the right. Like that. And now I should be able to jump to the left. I wonder if I want to get into the upper left platform. Fuck. It's not a full jump. I gotta remember that. Not a full jump. Remember that it's not a fucking full jump. Not a full jump. That is, however, a full jump. Okay, I made the mistake there of for some reason using a directional jump instead of a neutral one. I don't know why. But you know, it's pretty hard to remember every single jump, you know. In fact, if I even stream this again, remembering every fucking single jump Like, it's just not gonna happen, dude. It's so hard to remember a single champ, and then remembering them all again is just like... Yeah, it's too hard. Ooh, holy shit. Okay, this is nasty. This is just completely nasty. And it keeps getting even more nasty. So I need... It seems like I do indeed need to jump to that platform on the left. And that full jump was pretty questionable. I don't think... Dude, this is so fucking scary. You have no idea how scary this is. Oh, there is a church? Well, good to know. Fuck. So, apparently this is a full jump, full neutral jump. Yeah, it is a full neutral jump, but this one... I wonder about this one. Is this a full jump like that? No, yeah, that's not gonna be enough. Damn it. Okay, that works. And I'm pretty sure this is supposed to be that. There we fucking go. Oh, yes. Yes. The Chapel Perilous or whatever the fuck it was called. We reach a church. Is this because we need to pray? Isn't this pretty much a checkpoint? Isn't it like impossible to fall from here unless you really fuck it up? Because if I fall from either of these holes, like, I literally just have to jump back up. Yeah, that's what I'm asking. I feel like the only way you can fall from here is if you go to the left or to the right purposely. Yeah, seems like a legit checkpoint. Holy shit. Though, I don't know. Because maybe if you bounce hard enough, like if you bounce hard enough in that right or that left wall, maybe the momentum can fuck you up a lot. Maybe that's the only case where you will be able to fall. And I mean, this game will be more than happy to prove me wrong about how that is a checkpoint. Also, this seems to be wall-bound city right here. Right? Yeah, it seems like most of these are wall jumps. You can't fuck this up that much. No, I'm pretty sure I can fuck it up a lot. But I will try not to. The good thing is that I can choose... As I told you, this game automatically saves. So if I need to end the stream, which I might be able to need to end the stream soon enough. Maybe in half an hour I should end the stream. The good thing is that we can continue from here without problems. No, we don't need to input any passwords or anything like that. Don't worry. Damn, this is such a relief. I know that I'm probably gonna regret saying this because there's something that's gonna fuck me up. Because I think I remember streamers, maybe my memory is wrong because I don't remember seeing streamers get here. But maybe, like my memory tells me that one streamer got here and that it fell down. Like fell down to that place with the cozy house, you know, like where the sewers are. So, I don't know. I don't know if this is an actual, you know, quote-unquote checkpoint, right? I wouldn't be that sure. Though it definitely gives you a sense of safety. I don't know if that's a false sense of safety or not, but let's remember, the other good thing is that here you don't have to worry about wind. This is pure jumps, though the jumps are admittedly pretty hard, yes. But yeah. I think it's... Yeah. Unless... The only thing that I can think that can fuck us up is that, because I know that some levels, I think they have this. I don't know if it's in the main game or if it's in a DLC, but I think you see those black borders at the left and right side of the screen. I don't know if those are actually places where you can fall off. Because if that's true, then yes, you can. If you fall there, you're going back to the beginning of the game. Because I don't think there's anything that will avoid you from completely falling off. Okay, so what's in here? More chandeliers. Okay. What's up here? More chandeliers, nice. How do I get up here though? Yeah, that might be the hard part about this. Seems like this jump has to, like, from here I have to jump directly into that middle thing on the middle chandelier. By the way, is that how you pronounce that word? Chandelier? Or do you pronounce it differently? I think it is pronounced like that. Chandelier. Oh, chandelier. Okay, okay. Yeah, I think chandelier is the name of the Pokemon. So yeah, that might not be correct. Oh, I was supposed to jump to the fucking left. God damn it. Well, that's fine. I mean, honestly, I'm just happy that I've been able to reach this far. And with an almost guaranteed checkpoint. Almost. I still don't want to, you know, say it too much because I might chintz it. But this looks like a guaranteed checkpoint unless you are really distracted and you royally fuck it up. Which hopefully doesn't happen. I don't even know. Like, there is like a chorus, right? Like a pretty small, pretty distant chorus that you can listen to right now. I don't know if you can listen to it. I can, but it's pretty faint. You almost can't. Maybe there is like some shit going on down, like up there with some singers or whatever. It's a word coming from French. Interesting. Damn, these falls are gonna be brutal when you have to come from up there. They are definitely gonna be incredibly brutal. Okay. Oh no, 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 no. You're supposed to do a jump up here. Oh shit! We got a big ass cross. Wait, is that a platform? Wait, what's a platform? The ceiling, right? I think it is. How do I do this jump? Oh, a full jump works, surprisingly enough. Damn, what is this shit? The Blue Ruin. And this is the obligatory ice level. Because why not? Why not have a fucking ice level, right? And as you can see, it's pretty easy to understand. You land and you slide. So you're probably expected to jump immediately afterwards. Which, if you ask me, it's insanely brutal. But then again, it wouldn't be this game if it wasn't brutal, right? You know, I gotta be honest. I was about to, like, be like, you know, I will give up on this game. You know, I will play something else on the next stream. But now that I actually reached this far, and it seems like this is a semi-safe checkpoint, I really want to see the end of it. Because I feel like I can. I don't know how far we are from the end. But I know that it should be doable. Jump, slide, fall, die. Well, thankfully, that's the good thing about this game. You can die no matter how shitty of a player you are. It's just impossible to die. You just can't. Yeah, you die in real life? Yeah. Alright, that seems to make more sense. Damn, this is brutal. This fucking slide is brutal. Okay, so I tried to test it there. And basically, you cannot do much about that. You cannot do much about that in the sense that you have to... Fuck. Okay, see, as you can see, if you fall here, you should fall here. It's almost impossible to keep falling further down. Unless you really want to do it, right? Like, unless you're... Like the king of masochists, instead of the champ king, you're the king of masochists, and you want to fall. Then I don't think it's possible to just fall like that. Come on. Jump left. Also, I've been thinking about the music and everything, right? The problem with the music is that I feel like it will be a little bit anticlimactic. I know that as it is right now, it is pretty boring to have no music at all, but I feel like if I put music, it will completely ruin the atmosphere, but I don't know. Okay, you're supposed to do jumps in a row to combat the slide. So you can stop and think. There is no time for thinking. Checkpoint hype, I know, right? So yeah. That definitely gave me enough motivation to keep on streaming this. Though again, I don't know how long this is gonna take me. It might take me a while to do, but we will see. No, why did I do that, Sean? But sadly for Yami, you won't see me suffer other than in this area. Well, hopefully. Hopefully I don't gotta do anything that I've done so far again, because that will fucking suck. Like, that will make me want to stop playing if I had to do all that I done to reach this chapel again. Or this church. I don't even know what a chapel is supposed to... Oh, no, I do know what a chapel is supposed to be. We call this here capilla. That's how you call it in Spanish. Which is basically the pointy thing that a church has. Although in this case it seems like there is no church, there's only a chapel, which is alright. Sure, I don't mind. I don't like churches anyway, so... Learn Spanish with Gabby, I know. It's mostly about learn English, myself, and everyone else learns Spanish, yes. So, you know, around here in Argentina, we have a pretty weird spelling about the double L, right? Because double L in Spanish is usually pronounced like, well, like an L, but a little bit more acute, right? So, for example, a word like I said, capilla, that's how you pronounce that double L, because it's a double L. The problem is, for some reason, Argentinians don't like to pronounce that double letter, so instead, they pronounce it like a sh. Yeah, exactly, like that. like an S and an H for some reason. So obviously instead of Capilia is Capisha. I don't know why, but that's the case. And it seems like that's like Argentina only. I don't think that specific rule or quote-unquote rule, it's more like a tradition more than a rule, but I think that's only from here, right? I mean, yes, I know, as Kael is saying, every Spanish-speaking country has its own weird things, but I feel like that one, like pronouncing a double L as an S and an H, is Argentinian only, I think. Pretty sure it is. That's not a full champ. Are you serious? It's not a full champ. Oh, you can do that. That's even better. You can choose wall bounce and you will consistently get there if you do a full jump. Yeah, Argentina indeed. It is indeed a pretty interesting country, for better or for worse, right? It's a pretty interesting one for sure. Oh wow, that also works. Interesting. So I can just do that. Double wall bounce to get there. Okay, not that. Damn it, that's not. Why did I wall bounce there? Brazil. We must go to war. Damn, I didn't know, Yannick. I thought you were from, like, well, I thought you were from the Northern Hemisphere. I didn't even know you were from South America. Good shit. So we are three South Americans right here, huh? That's more than I expected to find. But yeah. For those who don't know, for some reason, well, I mean, there are reasons, though. They are mostly pretty stupid reasons, but Argentina is usually kind of like the enemy of a lot of the neighbor countries, right? And that's mostly, there are various, you know, reasons for that. So, for example, with Chile, it's usually about territory, right? A lot of the discussions between and the differences between Argentina and Chile are usually about that territory, because Chile has a pretty unfortunate territory. It's basically right next to the ocean, but at the same time it's covered by a huge ass mountain, right, that goes all the way from the north to the south. So they are in a pretty, you know, unfortunate location, and we basically don't give a shit. We are like, well, too bad, sucks to be you, right, or something like that. So that's one of the big reasons why there is some, you know, confrontations between Argentina and Chile. And when it comes to Brazil, it usually is mostly just for football, for the most part, at least nowadays, right? So, yeah. As I mentioned a couple streams earlier, people here will fucking go to war if it was for fucking football. It's just insane. It's something that it's hard to understand. But that's the case. And obviously Brazil is the first rival that you can think of, right? I mean, it's the strongest rival that you can think of in the continent. Obviously, when you get out of the continent, you get things like Germany, France, all those really strong teams. But usually, when it's about South America, Brazil and Argentina are the two big football teams. So obviously there's gonna be some rivalry. So yeah, that's the reason why. Hopefully it was useful. Probably not though, but yeah. Basically, South American only hours. That's how it is. I also remember there was another Brazilian guy in my chat, but I don't remember where he went. Soccer. Yeah, soccer. More like soccer. Am I right? Yeah, fucking soccer, dude. You know, when people ask me what team is my favorite, and I'm like, I don't like football. They look at me like I was some kind of alien. I mean, I didn't even mention that I'm a Toho fan, because if I mention that, then they will see what a true alien looks like. But no, I should say that I don't like football, and they already are like, damn. That can be, that does not compute. Team, that fucking chump. Oh, I tried to chump there because I thought I was gonna fall. Gabi, not a true Argentinian, I know, right? No, I think it's the first one. I think it's with an I. I think. I don't know. I usually don't need to write my nationality on English, so I'm not exactly sure. Ouch. Yeah, Argentina. Okay, yeah, I was right. What if I told you there is a Toho? I know, there is one that is based on the Captain Tsubasa game, I think, for the NES, if I'm not mistaken, or maybe the DS, the Nintendo I'm talking about, right? Yeah, basically all of the Toho characters have a special move where they do some crazy ass bullshit that will almost always, if not always, end in a goal. Yeah, I know it. I know the game, it's just that I didn't like the original game already, because I never watched Captain Tsubasa. That's something else that it's pretty weird on here, right? Usually a lot of people childhood show, aside from Dragon Ball obviously, was Saint Seiya and Captain Tsubasa. Now, both of those shows, I didn't watch them. Like, neither of them. I did not watch them. I kinda wanna watch Saint Seiya, but I'm not really interested in Captain Tsubasa, honestly. Here we call the anime Oliver and Benji. Well, here that anime was called, the Spanish equivalent of Super Champions. For some reason, I don't know why they decided to translate Captain Tsubasa as Super Champions. Again, in Spanish, not in English. So, I mean, I don't mind. I feel like it's even funnier that way, but isn't that shit hella old? Well, it is, but I mean, you gotta understand, here, like, when I was a kid, I used to watch Pink Panther. We're talking about Pink Panther, a show that is, I think, literally from the 60s, right? And you might be thinking, why? Well, that's because if you expect any show to come out on time to a place like this, then you're wrong. The theme song, I know, right? Super Campeones. Yeah, that's the name. People call it Oliver Benji. Yeah, that's also the fucked up thing. Obviously, the name of the protagonist was switched up as well. So, yeah, you didn't even have the name of the original characters. The theme is engraved in my memory. I mean, it's such a classic that it's pretty hard not to get it engraved in your memory. I can't remember watching it ever because too young. No, I definitely remember it. And I said in a stream, I don't remember when, but I remember saying it on stream. I remember that, you know, I obviously, when I was a kid, I watched a lot of cartoons, right? But the Pink Panther was one of the only cartoons that I could watch and it would legitimately make me laugh. Like, a lot of the other cartoons, I was like, oh, okay, that looks cool, but it never made me laugh even when it was supposed to, right? But the Pink Panther, it was so stupid, so silly that it had to make me laugh. Damn, it's still being aired. I'm pretty sure it's also still being aired in here. It's just that, well, obviously, I don't watch any television, so, you know, I wouldn't know. But yeah, it's probably still being aired. I mean, if they still air El Chavo, I'm pretty sure they will air the Pink Panther too. I mean, they will recycle anything that they can recycle. Especially since they don't even have enough money to buy any new shows. So, you know, they are out of luck. Out of luck, sorry. Had the alcoholic trainer, I don't know, because as I say, I never watched Captain Tsubasa, so I wouldn't know. But yeah, that basically, for those who don't know, that was the Holy Trinity in here. Dragon Ball, Captain Tsubasa, and Saint Seiya, those three animes were like the Holy Trinity. They are so popular in South America, you have no idea. I mean, Dragon Ball is kind of pretty much a religion around here. And in fact, speaking of Saint Seiya, even though I didn't watch it, I bought the game on Steam when it was on sale. Because I play the game and the game is fantastic, so I had to buy it. Obviously, it will have a little bit more impact if I actually watch the show and then play the game, but whatever. Can't have anything, right? I mean everything, not anything. Wonder how fucking long this ice section is gonna be. Probably pretty fucking long. I mean, it is to be expected. If you have such a big-ass checkpoint where it's impossible for you to fall to the abyss, I expect this section to be hard as fuck to make up for that fact. So yeah, this will probably take a shitload of tries, that's for sure. Oh, fuck. But as I said, the beautiful thing is that we don't need to fear. This is gonna get saved. I'm gonna try for the next stream to, I don't know what exactly yet, but to have some music running. Because otherwise it's just gonna be whack. That reminds me of something pretty interesting to think about. Does Steam allow you to run two games at the same time? I mean, I wouldn't see why not, but I never done it, so I don't know. Yes, nice. Because maybe I can run Fantastic Danmaku Festival 1. Or, well, not even that. I can run one of the Touhou games available on Steam, like Double Dealing Character or some shit like that. Nice, good shit. Yeah, so what I'm probably gonna do is have a Double Dealing Character will be a good idea, I feel, to have it running. You can run Action Capture Software and a game both from Steam. Mirelis Action? The fuck is Mirelis Action? Or better yet, do I want to know what it is? I think that's a more important question. Oh, it's a recording software. Alright. Silly chat. Making me think it was something else. But yeah. Well, I mean, I was gonna make a joke about playing one game with one hand and another with another hand. But if you play Mirror, it's pretty hard to use the hand that you're not using for playing for something else. Other than, you know. Yeah. Always overthinking. Hey! If there's anyone that cannot call me a pervert, it's you. Like, Yami... Nah, Yami also can't call me a pervert. Yami is like the most closest to the pervert I've seen. Like, holy shit. Talk about tsunderes, right? But yeah. This part is a little bit easy. You should do this and that. So, remember when I say that I actually watched a playthrough of one of the DLCs? Well, one of the DLCs is not as merciful as the main game, right? Because one of the DLCs, you might reach a certain point in the game where it's totally possible for you to fall right to the bottom. So, thankfully, this is pretty, you know, pretty generous, to say the least. That's some shade. I mean, am I wrong? I don't think I'm wrong. If there's anything that I'm pretty sure I'm not wrong, is that you never said you were. I'm pretty sure you said you weren't at some point. And even if you said you weren't, I mean, if you didn't say it, you will constantly deny it one way or another. Also, how the fuck am I supposed to do this? Is this a full jump to the left? Is that what you're telling me? Oh, it is. Oh, and it's an immediate jump right after, huh? Damn, this is gonna be trial and error city. Holy shit. That's fine. I'm used to trial and error. I'm a Touhou player after all. God damn it. That's definitely not true. I don't know. You also said you weren't a tsundere, but you definitely are. Can you believe it? Yami didn't know what a tsundere was, apparently. How do you not know what a tsundere is? That's like the most popular anime archetype that you can find everywhere. Well, I mean everywhere on every shitty slice of life anime, right? and also mech anime. Oh, that was the denial. Ah, I see. It wasn't the fact that he's a pervert or not. It's the fact that he's not a weeb. That was the denial. Thanks. I knew you were denying something, but I didn't remember what. It was that. Thanks. Thanks for reminding me. That was the denial. Good shit. Hey, that's fine, don't worry about it. As I say, everyone is welcome. Wait, what happens if I jump to the left from that left platform? Well, I don't think I'm gonna find out right now, but alright. God damn it. There we go. Okay. I think this is a pretty good place to leave this for now. I gotta say that I'm pretty surprised that I reached this far on the fucking first stream. But this definitely gave me enough incentive to keep playing. So that's really good. That's really good. And I definitely wanna see where, like, how far I can get. I know that at least I cannot, or I shouldn't be able to fall from here, right? So this should be it. But before I go, I want to make sure. You have a give up option and a save option? Huh. Oh, and that's an interesting... an interesting thing. Alright, save and exit. Are you sure? Yes. So apparently now that we saved it, we can just continue with no problem. Press numpad C. Yeah, that's because that's my jump. Okay. Well, I don't think I need to enter this, because I mean, I don't want the session thing to fuck up. I want the session to be legitimate. So I'm assuming that this saves just fine. Numpad. Yeah, that's the button I'm using for jumping. Because it's the best one, because you have the WASD on one hand and the SIDS 5 on the other. Obviously you don't use 5 here because you can shoot. So I can't believe the fucking main menu song has way more music than anything else in the game. We'll keep your secret. You fit only one or two criterias for weave. Alright, sure. I'll believe you. Anyways, so that's gonna be it for me for today. And I obviously wanna thank everyone a lot for watching. And I'll be seeing you all. Oh, I unlock an achievement called Fool's Paradise and it has the church emblem. So maybe me thinking that that's a good place makes me a fool. I don't know. Anyways. Thanks for watching and see you next time with more Shump King. Take care.